Hi viewers, this is Sri Ramulu. So please subscribe it before watching this video. So today's topic is particle in one dimensional box, or sometime we call it as particle in a box. Either particle in a box or particle in one dimensional box. And see here, the side is given. This is, it is a box having, so here let me read it first. Let us consider the case of a particle of mass m moving along x axis between the two rigid walls A and B at x is equals to 0 and x is equals to A. The particle is free to move between the walls. Okay. So here, this is a particle, it is a box, and this contains the particle. This is a particle having the mass m. Consider case of the particle mass m moving along x axis, in which axis it is moving along x axis. Let x axis is along, this is the direction of x axis, okay. And between the two rigid wall, so it is one wall and it is another wall, its name is A and its name is B. And boundaries of A is at x is equals to 0 and it is at x is equals to A, right? Now, the potential energy of the particle between the two walls is constant, okay? So between means between the two walls means in this region its potential energy is constant, and that is how much, you know, it is zero. Okay. So why? Because the particle is free to move, free particle. It is a free particle having the potential energy zero. But the potential energy is infinite at the walls. At this wall and at this wall, the potential energy is infinity. And see the conditions, boundary conditions, these are called boundary conditions. Potential energy is a function of x. So it is infinity when x value is less than 0 and x value is greater than a. X value less than 0 means this side, and x value greater than a means this side. So this side and this side potential energy is infinity. And from next, V of x is equals to 0. For 0 is less than, x is less than a. That means potential energy is 0 when x value lies between 0 and a. In between 0 and a, so Hindi, this is the region. In this region, potential energy is 0. The next point is from the Schrodinger time independent wave equation. So it is one of the application of the Schrodinger time independent wave equation. So it is a Schrodinger time independent wave equation in terms of h cut. Next, in terms of h, this is a equation. Okay, why? In the place of h cut, what we have substituted, we substituted h by 2 pi. Then we get this equation. As the potential energy 0 means V is equal to 0 between the walls, hence the equation has the following form. See, this equation is converted like this. Why? In the place of V, what we substituted? 0. There it is converted like this. And let me take the coefficient of psi, what we have, it is as a k square. Okay. So coefficient of psi, what we have, that is k square. So here k square is what? 8 pi square m by h square into e is equals to k square, right? Then the equation to becomes, so this equation, it is a equation to becomes, it is converted into like this. And this equation is equation 3, it is a second order differential equation. That means it must contain the solution. Okay, second order differential equation. The second order differential equation solution in terms of, in the form of sine of kx, cos of kx. Why it is k? Psi square term, what we have? K. Okay, so that is why in terms of k. So that equation is psi of x is equal to a sin kx plus b cos kx. So here a and b are the constant, and those constant we have to calculate by using boundary conditions. okay, here where A and B are the constants. These constants can be calculated by applying boundary conditions. Boundary conditions, see here, what are those boundary conditions? So in the equation 2, at x is equal to 0, psi of x 0, not only potential energy is 0 and also function psi function is 0 at x is equal to 0, and at x is equal to a also same thing will repeat, okay, at x is equal to same a also. So when we substitute x is equal to 0, then we get a b term. So and after substituting b term in this that equation, then we calculate a terms, that is latter. And x is equal to 0, at x is equal to 0, psi is 0. Substitute these two terms in this equation, then where there is a x, there substitute simply 0. So here you have the x 0, it is 0, and in this place also 0, right? And we know that cos 0 is term 1, sin 0 is 0. So 1 into b is become b only. So here b we get, and it is already 0. So this term is completely 0. B plus 0 is 0, is b, and then b is equals to 0. So this b term, where we have to substitute in the equation 4, we have to substitute. When the b term is 0, substituted in the equation b, then this term completely 0, then we get only this term, that is given in the next page. See, when the b value is substituted in the equation 4, then we got this one. And next, at x is equal to a, then also psi term is 0. Okay, substitute in this equation. Now in this equation, we have to substitute. So if psi of x is equal to a sin kx, in the place of x, what we have to substitute? A term. And in the place of psi, 0. Okay, here a is substituted and here 0 is substituted. Then bring a value this term, this side, that also 0. So then sin k is equal to 0. Okay. Sin k is 0. So at what angles of, at what values of k, sin term is 0? At the k, a is equal to substitute pi value. So that means here sin pi is 0. Sin 2 pi also 0. Sin 3 pi also 0. Then sin n pi terms, all n pi terms are 0. So that is why in the place of k, a, what is written? N pi is written. And from this k can be written as n pi by a. Right? K, a can be written as n pi by a. Next, substituting this k value in the equation 5. Okay, so that means in this equation. So in the place of k, what is substituted? N pi by a is substituted, right? So this is the function getting the psi value. And the next, energy of the particle. So how much energy it has? Already its potential energy is 0. Then what is the total energy of the particle? So total energy of the particle can be calculated as follows. Total energy of the particle can be calculated as follows. And already we know k value n pi by a. Squaring this term on both sides. Yes, squaring. Then what we get? This is we get k square, n square, pi square by a square. Okay. And so twice, two times it is written k square, pi square. Okay. Actually one time only we have to write, but two times is written. Okay. Nothing will happen. We know that k square term is what? 8 pi square m by h square only, not h square, h square only. So in the place of k square here, substitute this value, that means make these two terms equate. These two terms when we equate, then we get this is. From this, what are the values gets cancelled? Pi square cancelled. Okay. Only pi square term will cancel. Next. After square cancelling the pi square terms, then these are the remaining. Keep only e term this side and bring h square and 8m that side. Then the equation becomes like this. Okay. Or in terms of h cut, the equation is like this. This is the total energy of the particle when it is present inside a box. Okay. And if you substitute n value 1. Then what you get? If you substitute n value 0, then this is the ground state energy. Okay, so energy also 0. Why? In the place of n substitute 0, then the total term 0, then energy also 0. And next, substitute n is equals to 1, in this equation, then you get this value. Substitute n is equals to, then you get this one. So 3, then why it is written as n, e1, n, e2? So e1 value is, we got this one. And the next time what we get, if you substitute in the place of n as 2, then you get 4 into pi square h cut square, pi square h cut square by 2m l square you get. So here already this is a term of e1. So we e1 term. So this is e1 term. So that is why e2 can be written as 4e1. Okay, like this 9e1, 16e1 we can write. So up to here only it is a syllabus for the UGR integrated chemistry students. And next, if you want to write extra term, even psi function also, if you want to calculate, you can calculate by using this equation. Okay. So wave function of the particle in 1D box. In 1D means one dimensional box. That is the meaning of 1D. Okay. It is already, we know the equation. This equation, psi of x is equals to a sin kx. The constant A of the above equation is obtained by applying this normal, applying this normalization condition. What is the normalization condition? In general, I am writing. Here, infinity plus infinity to minus infinity, psi star psi into dx is equals to 1. It is general formula. Okay. So, star term here, star means it is for complex terms only we use. But complex means I terms, in which the equation I terms comes, that is a complex, means Ix plus, like this, Ix plus Jy, like these are the questions. So such a questions, for such questions only this term is used. But here psi and psi star both same. So psi, whatever psi you get, if you complement it, then you get the same term. So that is why psi, instead of writing psi star, we write simply psi of x whole square. So why? Psi star into psi star, psi square, that's it. Okay, psi square. So psi is a function of x, that is why it is a psi of x whole square into dx is equals to 1. It is called normalization condition. So here if you calculate only a value, then that is a wave function. Okay, for the calculating, for this purpose only we are applying the normalization condition. This is the normalization condition. And the substitute psi of x in the place of psi of x, this term, then you get this one. And see next term, k value. So k value already we know n pi by a. So that is also substituted. Now take a outside. Already whole square is there. If you take outside, it becomes a square. And now it is sine n pi by x whole square. Okay. So whole square means it is sine square. Sine square integration, there is no integration. So for sine square there is no integration. Then what we have to do? Sine square we must convert it like this. Sine square can be written, sine x can be written as, sorry, it is not square here, not square. Okay, so here 1 minus, already what is the formula? Sine square theta formula is 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2 only. There is no whole square like this, not no whole square, only 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2 only. So that is why, and 2 is also forgotten here also may get the 2 by 2. Okay, so already by 2 is there. And now integrating this bracket, then what we get? Okay, integrating. Yes, yeah, square is written, not square. Okay, sorry for that. Okay, so here 1 by 2 is taken outside, and integration of 1 with respect to x is x only. Cos integration is what? Cos integration, it is a sine x, actually whatever term present, that is. So x coefficient, whatever x coefficient present, that is by right, by we have to write n pi by a, we have to write, it is written already here in reverse. So a by n pi, 2 n pi, okay, 2 pi n r, 2 n pi, and limit where, 0 to a. Why? Our potential box has a limit 0 to a only. And substituting the, these conditions, upper and lower condition limits, then we get this is. So when you substitute a value here or zero value, then this total term is zero. If you substitute a or zero, why, you know, see here why it is zero. Here sine of 2n pi by a into x is there. In the place of x, first substitute a term, upper limit we have to substitute. Then minus lower limit. Upper limit is what? Upper limit is a. A gets cancelled. 2n pi. So write n is equals to 1. What do you get? 2 pi. 2 pi for every 2 pi, 3 pi, 4 pi, 5, 6 pi. For such values, sine value is 0. Okay. Next is what? At the zero time, sine of 2n pi by a into x. The place of x substitute 0. 0 into everything is 0. Sine of 0 is also 0. So because of that, only this total term 0, only this term remains constant. And if substitute a term here, a limit a minus 0 becomes a only. So that is why here a is written. Okay. I think you have understood why if this equation has come. And bring a small a and to that side, then 2 by a. And bring square also that side, it is become under root. Okay. Now substitute a term in the equation 7. Seventh equation is this. Seventh equation is what? Psi of x is equals to capital A sine of n pi by a into x. In the place of a, what is substituted? This is substituted. So this is the equation of psi. Okay, so equation, let it is 8. 8 represent the wave function of the particle enclosed in infinity deep a potential well. Infinity means walls of the potential already written here, infinity and infinity. So that much of a deep, it is very much deep potential. And the wave function psi 1, psi 2, psi 3. So here, if you substitute n value here, then what you get? That is a psi 1. And if you substitute 2 value in the place of n, what you get? That is psi 2. So that is written here. Okay. So psi corresponding to n as shown in figure. So this is a figure in this figure. So thank you, friends. So this is the explanation. And don't forget correcting this square here, not square present here and where and here. In these two point cases only not square, and here square right only. Thank you, friends.